Hi everyone, I'm Philip Griffiths. I'm not going to tell you which band I sing in because that would be a shameless plug and we simply cannot have that. All I'm going to say is this, you are watching Live Frog, a great new concert, so enjoy.
There are a lot of things that can be the inspiration for music, but I found that if you draw musical inspiration from personal experiences or memories or personal stories, that the whole music gets a different emotional charge. Now, such a story is presented on this album by Fuchs, Leaving Home. Fuchs is actually Hans-Jürgen Fuchs, and well, from what I gather on his website, this is so far the only album he made. And a very interesting one, which is completely based on a family story, well, from many years ago. I'll open up the booklet, tell you a little bit more, and show you a little bit more about the inside and who's involved in this project. This is the man, Hans-Jürgen Fuchs. And in English and in German, he explains what this album is all about. And it's, as he says here, and I quote literally, "Leaving home is my father's family story, more or less told as my grandma Hildegard saw it. It starts in 1920 and it ends in 1945. So after the First World War and during the Second World War. So it's a very, well, it's not a happy tale. It's a very sad tale, as you can imagine. And a lot of events that all directly connected with the family are described in the music. He does say, and I quote again, "This story so far has never been completely told and is therefore mosaic-like based on my subjective memory of some old anecdotes. Some things were added for dramatical reasons." So he's, you know, going back in his memory and anecdotes from the family, and he used that as a sort of base to create the story of this album. I was telling you about the artwork. Well, there's not a lot of artwork in it. It's more lyrics, but in between, you know, in the back, you can see some things. The most interesting part is in the middle. That is this one. I'll bring it a little closer so you can see. These photos, they're from his personal family album. So again, that brings it all of a sudden much closer to home, because he's kind of giving you a look inside his life, and he does that in a musical way. That's the story behind it all. Now, there are a lot of people involved in this project. I wouldn't call it a band, I would call it a project. The main man is, of course, Hans-Jürgen Fuchs, who wrote everything. He does vocals on several tracks. He does guitars, lap steel, bass, piano, and keyboards. Have a few other vocalists, Bagi Buchmann, Miriam Michuta, Andy Kefer, and Sven Heine. A lot of different vocalists are used on the album. Sometimes there are songs that have a male and female vocals in it, which is very nice. Well, then there are a few persons who do some additional work, like a synth solo, a piano solo, a guitar solo. There's also a cello on a few tracks, which is very nice. And then we have covered everything. So there's some classical touches to it. Music-wise, it's really hard to put together. And you know, us reviewers like to stick labels on it. But with this album, it's very difficult, because throughout the songs, you hear all kinds of different styles in it. And they all range from actual real progressive rock to symphonic parts to more melodic rock AOR parts, even some poppy parts in it. Some orchestral touches to it. So it's a lot of everything. And when I talk about a lot, just look at the track listing. As you can see, it has 16 tracks. Hans Fuchs takes a lot of time to tell his story. The total running time of the album is 75 minutes, so there's a lot to listen to. I gotta say, it's quite lengthy, maybe a little too lengthy, but at the same time, it's very nice to listen to the album. So there's every song is different from the other, so it's really hard to you know, give you a general description of the whole album, because the sounds are quite different. But at the same time, that makes it interesting to listen to, because there's a lot of variety in it. A couple of things that I really noted that really stand out are some really fantastic guitar solos. Track number 5, Life in Balance, track number 8, Symphony in Disguise, and the last track, Leaving Home, have some really fantastic guitars in it. Sometimes this song has a really dramatic piano opening, as we find in the third track, Such a State of Affairs, Part 1. We span between life and death. Round is trembling, makes you pray to a God who's far away. All these people trapped in silence, now trapped in dismay. Emotions are conveyed, you know. It's sometimes there's a really sad atmosphere breathing towards the songs, and it's really beautiful to listen to. Production-wise, I think there is some work to be done here. At certain points, especially the guitars come out of the speakers quite—I don't know how to say it—quite heavy. That they really hit you. I was playing the album on a fairly okay volume, and after a couple of songs, I really started to get a little bit of a headache. So I just put the volume down a bit. Maybe it would have been nice in the production to just shave off the edges a little bit, you know, not musically but sonically more. But you know, that's my only point of criticism I have for this album. The production, it could have been a bit warmer, you know, not as sharp as sometimes, and that mainly goes for the guitars. In other songs, you really hear the nice, the warm, pleasant bass, you know, cushioning up the whole song, making it feel very good. One other thing that I noticed, and I really gotta mention it, if you listen to this album, compare the final track, track 16, Leaving Home, with High Hopes from Pink Floyd. For some reason, I was listening to Leaving Home, and immediately I thought of High Hopes, and it's not that they are the same, but I think they convey a bit of the same mood, the same feelings, the same emotions in it. It's interesting to compare those two songs, and the whole Pink Floyd idea in the guitar solos, I also got a little bit of an idea, like, this is a little bit like Gilmore, you know? Not the same, but the reference is there. Maybe you hear it differently, I don't know. So I gotta say, it's a really pleasant album, a very nice album to listen to. So, well, the artwork are just drawings, as you can see. Well, I got nothing more to add about that. So, well, Fuchs, Leaving Home, very interesting album for you to check out.